of this season, and Greg Funfgeld's final Bach at Noon. It's hard to say without tearing up. 17 years ago, he founded this program at Central Moravian Church. What a gift it is, and we are so grateful to him. Today, we have received a special challenge grant to support this series, and this month, in honor of our artistic director, Greg Funfgeld. And three individuals have contributed $2,500 as a challenge grant. We are taking everyone's generous donations to make sure that this program continues in honor of Greg. So you'll find envelopes in your programs, and you can also donate after the fact online or through a check. We also have a German film crew here with us today who has been embarking on a three-year documentary of Bach ensembles, Bach choirs over the world. I think in South Africa, Paraguay, and in Belgium, and here. So we have a place in their film. I want you to welcome with me today the Schmidt Film and their team. And I also, trying to remember the third thing that I'm supposed to say to you, but I would like to welcome very much Greg Funfgeld to the stage with Mary Watt and Elizabeth Field. And the third thing I wanted to say to you is come to our festival. It's May 13th and 14th, and May 20th and 21st, you'll find the program, the brochure in your seats. And please enjoy this program. Thank you.
You are most kind, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I thought it might be interesting to remember that day back in 2005 when we were about to do our first Bach at Noon. And we were planning to do this 1210 concert. It was a free concert, open to anybody who wished to come. And the night before, I think I was awake all night wondering, would anybody come? And the next morning, we were here and we were rehearsing. We did the first Brandenburg Concerto and Cantata 65, because it was around Epiphany, and that's an Epiphany cantata. And like the Brandenburg, it required horns and oboes, so we had all the instruments. And I was up most of the night wondering, would anybody come other than my beloved wife, Nancy, and a few close friends? And sure enough, we rehearsed, and then when they opened the doors, there were people lined up down the street and around the corner, and the church was filled. So then a month later, I spent another sleepless night wondering, would anybody come back? And wonder of wonders, we opened the doors, and there was another large group of people eager to come in and hear the music of Johann Sebastian Bach. So since then, January of 2005, we have been doing Bach at Noon at this beautiful church. We're so grateful to Hopeton Clennon and his staff and the congregation of this church for the use of this beautiful space, these wonderful acoustics. Everything about this place is just great. So Hopeton, thank you very much. 121 Bach at Noons later, here we are. And you've heard dozens and dozens and dozens of cantatas, Brandenburg concertos, other concertos, sonatas, all kinds of music by different composers, as well as lots of music by Bach. It's been a really incredible experience for all of us. And so today, for this last one, we're in the middle of Holy Week. So our cantata is an Easter cantata. We'll talk about that in a moment. But our instrumental work is a concerto for oboe and violin. And I picked this because it gave me a chance to collaborate with two esteemed and beloved colleagues, Elizabeth Field, our concertmaster, and Mary Watt, our principal oboist. So would you give them a warm welcome, please?
Thank you.
This is a large orchestra for this cantata. There are three kind of, you could call them choirs in the orchestra. The timpani and trumpets are the first, then four oboes, three oboes and an English horn, and then the strings. So there are lots of instruments in the orchestra, and they're going to get settled now, and then the choir will come. This is a cantata that Bach wrote when he had just turned 30 years of age, in 1715. This was the cantata for Easter Sunday in the church in Weimar. Bach wrote this and one other cantata for Easter Day, cantata 4, Christlag in Todesbanden. Of course, there's the Easter Oratorio, and then there are cantatas for the days following Easter. It was a three-day feast in the church. It was the pivotal feast of the Lutheran liturgical year. It was the most important day in the liturgical calendar. Now, this piece starts with what Bach calls a sonata. Sometimes there's an instrumental piece at the beginning of a cantata, and it can be called a sinfonia. Here he calls it a sonata. And we're going to play a couple of examples for you in a minute. Then comes the chorus, this beautiful chorus about the heavens laughing and the earth rejoicing. And it's very much like the Gloria from the Mass in B minor, or some of those very festive choruses with trumpets and timpani. If you look at number 3 in your program, there are 3 recitatives and 3 arias that follow the sonata and the opening chorus. And these recitatives are all masterful. They're really quite extraordinary. The bass voice is first. And one of the things I'd like you to listen for in the bass recitative number 3 is Bach's use of canon. Canon is when one voice starts and a second voice follows it in imitation, kind of like row, row, row your boat, you know, very simple canon. But in Bach's text painting here, he shows that as Jesus has risen and goes forth into new life, we follow him. And so he uses the musical device of a canon. The voice of the bass, who is the voice of Christ, leads, and the instruments follow, the cello and the organ in the recitative. The fourth movement is a bass aria, and it starts off talking about the Prince of Life, the mighty warrior, the exalted Son of God. And the rhythm is very dotted and jagged, kind of like a French overture, music that depicts royalty. Ba-bum, 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 ba-bum. Very elegant, very stately. The tenor aria that comes later, number 6, on the top of your next page, talks about Adam must first decay for the new person to be born. And this is a beautiful aria. We were talking about the only bad thing about this aria is it's too short. And the accompaniment in the strings, it's almost like a rocking, like a lullaby of the new creature that comes in the resurrection, the new person to be born, created in the likeness of God. So there's a lullaby quality to this. Then the soprano recitative comes, and the soprano then has a duet with the oboe, Mary Watt again. And this is a beautiful effect. The oboe and the soprano share melodic ideas and melodic invention. And in the background, the unison violins and violas play a hymn called When My Last Hour Has Come. And if you read the words, it says, final hour, sound your knell and press my eyelids shut. Let Jesus' joyous glow and radiant light be my vision. Let me be like the angels. And I like this movement. I liken it to an In Paradisum. If you know the Requiem Mass, the last movement is In Paradisum, where you go into heaven. And this movement, it feels almost like it leaves earth and ascends into heaven. It's very, very beautiful. And then the final chorale with a wonderful trumpet descant. Now, Let's go back to the sonata, the first movement in this cantata. I want you to listen to the theme that's played in unison in the orchestra. And this is a picture of the resurrection. Bum, 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 bum. And it keeps going up. We're going to play for you the first seven bars. And listen to this.
Two and a one.
Hear that bum bum rising figure, and very muscular in unison. Everybody's playing the same thing together. Listen to that one more time. The same thing one more time. Two and a one. Now, following that, the trumpets start a dialogue. Ya-da-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dum. It's almost like they start to dance after this fanfare, this picture of the resurrection. Then comes a dance of jubilation. So we're now going to play the first 11 measures for you. Listen to what happens after that opening fanfare. Two and a one. So you hear how that dance starts. After the opening fanfare, all of a sudden there's this very jubilant dance. Now, if you look at the chorus, number two, the choir comes in with these words, "The heaven laughs and the earth rejoices." Now, I want you to listen to the sopranos. This is what is called text painting, where Bach actually paints a picture of the musical idea. So we're talking about the heavens laugh. And Bach writes lots of notes, little notes on the word laugh. The sopranos are going to sing this for you. This is a very challenging thing to sing. So listen to them and send them good vibes. Cheer them on. Okay? Can we have the pitch? Ready? One and two and. So you hear that la, it's almost like you can hear the laughter. Listen to it one more time. Three and four and. Now, you're going to hear all of this music together. We're going to start with the sinfonia, the sonata at the beginning, and then we go right into that, and then the three recitatives and arias. So here is Cantata 31. And with it, we wish you a very blessed Holy Week and Easter.
stehenden du gottergebne Seele mit Christo geistlich auf, tritt an den neuen Lebenslauf auf von den toten Werken. Lass, dass dein Heiland in dir lebt, an deinem Leben merken. Der Weinstock, der jetzt blüht, trägt keine toten Reben. Der Lebensbaum lässt seine Zweige leben. Ein Christ flieht ganz eilend von dem Grabe. Er lässt den Stein, er lässt das Tuch der Sünden dahinten und will mit Christo leben sein. Auferstehen und aus Sünden gräben gehen, wenn du Christi Gliedmaß bist, wenn du Christi Gliedmaß, wenn du Christi Gliedmaß bist.
Funfeld, friend and inspiring presence. Thank you. Thank you for 39 years of excellence as the artistic director of the Bach Choir of Bethlehem. Thank you for 17 years and 4 months of fantastic music on Tuesdays at noon. Would anybody come? Offered for free to the public. Thank you for taking the spiritual dimension of the music of Johann Sebastian Bach seriously and inviting your audience to hear the proclamation of the fifth evangelist through Bach's devotion and his interpretation of the biblical text. Thank you for having the heart of a teacher. Even as you celebrate Bach's passion for teaching, teaching people how to compose chorales, talking about music written with 14 measures or 14 notes, thank you for being a blessing to the Lehigh Valley, across the United States, and so many regions of the world. Would anybody come? I came for the first time on March 12th, 2013. And I'm holding in my hand the program from that Bach at noon. And I came back. On March 12th, 2013, this is what Greg told all of us. He said, the believer has to follow Christ and take up his cross. There is a weight we carry, but not without some joy. There is also a deep sense of peace. So said Greg. As a church musician yourself, you may remember the tune and lyrics of A Blessing by Natalie Sleeth, written about the time this New Yorker moved to the Lehigh Valley, written in 1975. It's a canon, and it says, go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord's countenance be lifted upon you and give you peace. Amen.